Good morning, friends. Monday morning. It's 11 a.m. right now, so I think I'm going to go to a little coffee shop and do some Bible reading and catch up on some stuff that I need to do for that. Some Bible homework, I guess you can say. And then, yeah, we'll see where the day leads me. Maybe we'll talk about some books today or something. I don't know. We'll see. It's usually what I talk about, isn't it? So anyways, I'm going to continue on my walk with Wyatt, and you're welcome to join me. But I just wanted to say hello and good morning, and let's have a beautiful day. It is gorgeous out. Perfect weather. So because I feel like there's going to be some people who are going to ask and who are going to wonder what is around Wyatt's face, it is not a muzzle. It's just a gentle leader. It helps him not pull me, and he walks so nice when he's on the gentle leader, and it gives me more control of him. He's a very good walker when he decides to be, but there are occasions where he is full-blown puppy, and he's a big puppy. He's about 60, maybe close to 70 pounds now. So he's a big boy. He is not little, and he could definitely hurt me or somebody else if anything happened and he got it too excited or pulled or whatever. This definitely just eliminates the pulling, and he doesn't like it when he gets pulled. I don't like it when I get pulled. So, you know, we gotta make it comfortable for everybody. All right, it may seem like Wyatt didn't go on a walk today, right? It seems like he just has unlimited energy. 10:45, I've been letting him hang out, play for a little bit, get some of his wiggles out, and now I'm gonna start heading out, grabbing my stuff, and going to the coffee shop. But this dog of mine needs some water, and then is gonna go to the crate for a little bit. I'm walking to the coffee shop, and a lady had her dog, and she was really sweet, but she goes, "You can't go to school." And I'm like, "I'm not going to school, but I guess I do kind of look like a school kid because I'm wearing a backpack, like a purse backpack, and I'm carrying my Bible. So do I look like a schoolgirl?" Well, apparently I do. Love that for me. Enjoyed my time at the coffee shop and just studying and getting to just take a couple hours. I think I spent 2 hours, maybe close to 3 hours. The things that I took away from my Bible reading today, I was in Genesis a little bit, Exodus, Galatians, Ephesians, Psalms. Those were kind of the books that I was in today and reading through. Don't miss God in the mundane things. Like I was reading about Moses in the burning bush and how Moses noticed it, and he went back to go look at it, and then the bush spoke to him, or God spoke to him through the bush. But it's like, think about it, like, it's a bush, and then it happened to become on fire, and it was burning. A bush is such a mundane thing, such a simple thing, and God still spoke to Moses. And even with how God spoke through the rock, if you guys remember that passage in somewhere, it talks about how God, water poured out, and that's living water. That's another example of Jesus providing and him being the rock and the foundation, and I just think it's really cool. But all of those things, God is showing signs of himself through simple little things. So I guess my thing is, don't miss God. Don't. What I notice a lot in the Bible is these people were looking for, the Israelites were looking for some miraculous, crazy, significant sign of God. They missed it. He was right in front of them the whole time, but it was because their hearts were so set on how they had to see him. And even in the New Testament, the Sadducees and the Pharisees were so set that it had to be a certain way that they missed him the whole time. They missed it. They missed the whole thing because they were so set on seeing him a certain way. Don't expect God to show himself the way that you want. He's going to show himself the way he desires to show up to you. And I guess that's my little message today, is just don't miss it. Don't miss him, because he shows himself, but we can't be so set on our plans. You know what I mean? Anyways, go back home and just hang out for a little bit, see my family, and see what the rest of the day brings. By the way, I'm not out of shape from walking home. I was sick all last week, so I'm still kind of recovering a little bit. I mean, I'm not like sick anymore, just like, you know when you get pretty sick and then you're like kind of like catching up just from like exerting any type of energy? That's what's going on. So anyways, I am not like super out of shape, although I really am out of shape, but we're not going to talk about that, okay? Just, I don't want to work out. Don't judge. So I'm back home. I am sitting down. I am going to show you guys something that I'm excited to do, actually, that I haven't done yet, but I'm going to sit down and do it today. So I saw this on Instagram, I believe. I don't know who it was by, but I'll do a screen recording and show you guys. I saw this girl on Instagram. She just took a normal like planner, calendar, whatever, and in the like grid overview or whatever, the month overview, she just wrote like the Bible verse that stuck out to her. She writes it in these spots instead of like her days. She'll just write a Bible verse that stuck out to her, and I loved this idea so much, because for my morning study time, I'm gonna be really honest. I feel like I'm not like fully paying attention, and I feel like if I know that I wanna be able to write something that stuck out to me, a verse that stuck out to me, I have to be paying attention. So I know that sounds bad. I pay attention, obviously. It's just not as focused as I'd like to be. I specifically wrote down verses that stuck out to me so that I could fill them in, because this was last week's Bible reading. I just didn't do any Bible reading last week, so I was feeling a little guilty today. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and do last week's Bible reading so that way I can fill out the verses for last week, or so I can fill out the boxes for last week, because I really wanted to do that, but I was just so sick that I couldn't. So I'm kind of doing it a week behind right now, but I'll be caught up by tomorrow and I'll be able to do it at the right days. But today I'm just going to focus on last week's. But anyways, I'm going to try this and I'll come back to you when I have filled this out. You might see me filling it out, but that's kind of boring. So I'll just come back when I'm done. Okay. All right. Sayonara. All right. I did the challenge. I went ahead and did it. This is the first week. I think it looks really, really cute. Again, I'll share the person that I got this idea from. I thought it was so cute and I just had to do it, and I'm so excited about it. I think it's such a cute idea. I think it's gonna really help just to really like keep the things that I'm reading in my brain for the week. So yeah. Anyways, I of course would do it every day, not like a whole week at the same time. Anyways, I think that's gonna be it for today. I think I'm gonna go ahead and sign off. It's 3:30, so it is becoming evening time. My family's not really doing anything crazy today. I am just going to probably hang out, clean up my room, like just boring things, clean up my room, and then read my book for the week. Actually, I can share that with you guys. I'll have it right here. So I am reading The Girl Who Could Breathe Underwater by Erin Bartels. I think that this is going to be kind of mysterious, maybe a little bit scary. I was kind of hoping for that, but to be honest with you, I have no idea, but it kind of sounds scary to me. So I don't know. I'm going into it blind. I got this at a discounted bookstore. I got it for $3. So like, what a steal. Anyways, I'm gonna go. I love you guys so very much. Thank you so much for coming along with me for my day, and well, for most of my day. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys whenever I see you next. You know, I don't know what I'm doing yet. So Yeah. Bye!